Hey there! This will be a supplementary video for part 10 of our Metroidvania series, where we bring you through updates like bug fixes and code optimizations, as well as solutions for problems you may encounter. First on our list is the boss dive and barrage attacks not functioning while the player is near the boss. The cause is for missing code in the boss idle script not having any code to reset the boss velocity for falling down. We'll fix this by creating an if statement checking for the Hollow Knight's grounded bool to be false before setting the Y velocity to negative 25. Next, the boss can get stuck on walls. Whenever the boss wants to travel to attack in midair, they travel towards the target's move towards position, which should be above the player. However, they won't stop traveling until they reach the target, even if they are stopped by a wall. Thus, we'll need to create a way for the boss to check if they are touching the wall. We'll do this by creating a duplicate of the variable public transform ground checkpoint as wall checkpoint. Then we'll do the same for public bool grounded, renaming it touched wall. Finally, we'll replace all ground checkpoint with wall checkpoint in touch wall. After creating the duplicate of grounded, we'll create a new if statement into the following scripts: boss bounce 1, boss jump, boss bend down. This if statement will check for touched wall before setting the x value of move to position to their current position. Then we'll reset underscore new pause using the same code as it was set to above. With that, just copy and paste the code for all three scripts. Before we move on, note that you need to have two things for this to work. 1. Create a new game object to act as the wall checkpoint variable, like ground checkpoint. Place the game object towards the side of the boss that is facing forwards. And 2. The wall itself needs to have the same layer as the ground. This is because we copied and pasted the grounded method's code for touch wall, which uses the layer what is ground. For our third improvement, our player isn't entering invincibility nor stopping time when hit by the boss. Since our boss has multiple scripts with separate ways of dealing damage, like with the previous improvement, we'll need to set up our fix individually. I'll start off by demonstrating the simple fix with THK events. We'll need to find the main method that calls the player's take damage method in the script. Then, we'll add the condition of checking for whether the player is not in the invincible state. This should prevent the player from taking damage when in invincible state. Next, we'll add another if statement right after take damage is called to check if the player's state is still alive. If it is, we'll call hit stop time. Finally, we'll reuse this fix for the following scripts: boss lunge, diving pillar, barrage fireball, and THK events if you haven't already done so. For the next improvement, it's for the boss that can be hit during their death animation, resetting it. This will be a fairly quick solve as we'll only need to stop death from being called in the enemy gets hit method under the chain states code. We'll do this by adding a condition for the boss to be alive to call death only once. Fifth on our list is to prevent the player from activating SpawnBoss without entering the boss fight and is locked out. This is simply caused by the player being able to move and negate the velocity of SpawnBoss script's coroutine walk into room. Quickly solve this by setting the player controller instance PState cutscene to true inside the walk into room coroutine. This should prevent the player from controlling themselves while walking into the room. The cutscene state should set itself to false soon after, as the walk into new scene method is called in the player controller script. Last on our list of improvements, we'll create a way for us to save whether the boss has been defeated or not. We'll do this by first setting up a public bool called THKDefeated in our save data script. Then we'll follow the same steps as we created the shade and bench data methods. Create a file in initialize method by copy-pasting the same code and changing out the path for save boss data. Then, duplicate the bench or shade save and load data, renaming it as save boss data and load boss data, but change any bench or shade to boss. In save boss data, we'll set THK defeated to game manager instance THK defeated, which is another bool we'll make later, before writing it. As for load boss data, we'll read the bool THK defeated before setting the game manager instance THK defeated to it. Next, we'll need to set up this bool that we're using from the game manager script. Just create another public bool, THK defeated, to false. Then, in awake, at the bottom of the method, call loadBossData. This will change the defeated status of the boss to whatever was saved in save data to the game manager. Now to change THK defeated to true, we'll go to the THK events script. Find destroyAfterDeath method and add 3 lines of code. Set game manager instance THK defeated equals true before calling save boss data and save player data. This should effectively save the game to after you kill the boss. Finally, putting the bool to use, we'll go to the spawn boss script. In awake, first add an if statement to check if the boss exists in the scene before destroying it and setting call once to false, and collision is trigger to true. This is because in some cases, dying to the boss will not cause it to despawn. Then, add an if statement to check if the game manager's THK defeated bool is true. If it is, then set call once to true, effectively stopping the boss from ever spawning. However, we'll also add a safety measure in method onTriggerEnter2D, where we'll add an extra condition in the if statement to check if the THK defeated bool in game manager is not true before spawning the boss. With that, you should now be able to save the data of your boss completion status. Before we round up on part 10, we'll quickly address the boss not taking damage. Just ensure that in the Hollow Knight scripts method enemy hit, there is a line of code in the else statement to set parrying to false. With that, we close on part 10. I hope this video has solved your issues and improved your mechanics for part 10 of the Metroidvania series. There will be a link in the description regarding these changes made to part 10 of the series that will cover all of the fixes discussed in the video. If you have a problem or question that has not yet been covered or is a unique circumstance, do head to our community forums at blogterrascore.com in the description for assistance. Thanks for watching, and hope you enjoyed the video.